Holy Spirit be with all of you.
And with your spirit.
My brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins, so as to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned, in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done, and what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. Show gracious favor, O Lord, we pray, to the works of penance we have begun, that we may have strength to accomplish with sincerity, the bodily observances we undertake. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord God, cry out full-throated and unsparingly. Lift up your voice like a trumpet blast. Tell my people their wickedness, and the house of Jacob their sins. They seek me day after day, and desire to know my ways, like a nation that has done what is just, and not abandoned the law of their God. They ask me to declare what is due them, pleased to gain access to God. Why do we fast, and you do not see it? Afflict ourselves, and you take no note of it. Lo, on your fast day, you carry out your own pursuits and drive all your neighbors. Yes, your fast ends in quarreling and fighting, striking with wicked claw. Would that today you might fast so as to make your voice heard on high? Is this the manner of fasting I wish of keeping a day of penance, that a man bow his head like a reed and lie in sackcloth and ashes? Do you call this a fast, a day acceptable to the Lord? This, rather, is the fasting that I wish, releasing those bound unjustly, untying the thongs of the yoke, setting free the oppressed, breaking every yoke, sharing your bread with the hungry, sheltering the oppressed and the homeless, clothing the naked when you see them, and not turning your back on your own. Then your light shall break forth like the dawn, and your wound shall quickly be healed. Your vindication shall go before you, and the glory of the Lord shall be your rear guard. Then you shall call, and the Lord will answer. You shall cry for help, and he will say, here I am. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A heart contrite and humble, O God, you will not spurn.
A heart contrite and humble, O God, you will not spurn.
Have mercy on me, O God, in your goodness. In the greatness of your compassion, wipe out my offense. Thoroughly wash me from my guilt, and of my sin, cleanse me.
A contrite, humble heart, O God, you will not spurn.
For I acknowledge my offense, and my sin is before me always. Against you only have I sinned, and done what is evil in your sight.
A contrary, humble heart, O God, you will not spurn.
For you are not pleased with sacrifices. Should I offer a burnt offering, you would not accept it. My sacrifice, O God, is a contrite spirit, a heart contrite and humble, O God, you will not spurn.
A heart contrite and humble, O God, you will not spurn. Glory and praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
The disciples of John approached Jesus and said, "Why do we and the Pharisees fast much, but your disciples do not fast?" Jesus answered them, "Can the wedding guests mourn as long as the bridegroom is with them? The days will come when the bridegroom is taken away from them, and then they will fast." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. In the Hebrew scriptures of the Old Testament, we understand that they fasted very, very much. But their fasting was an obligation to the law. So there is something good in fasting, but there's something much deeper of why they fast or should be fasting. Isaiah prophesied about it in today's first reading, and Jesus speaks about it because he fulfills the Old Testament by his very life. Jesus is the fulfillment of the law. And he explains to us what kind of fasting he desires. The fasting to release prisoners, to feed the hungry, to give drink to the thirsty, to clothe the naked. That's worth more than any fast or burnt offering or sacrifice. So for much fasting, now we have 2 days of fast, possibly three, and I'll explain that. Ash Wednesday and Good Friday, within the context of Lent. But in the Paschal Triduum, or the Easter Triduum, you know, Holy Thursday, Good Friday, and the Easter Vigil Night Watch, there is a day of fast called the Paschal Fast on Holy Saturday, because that's the day in which Jesus is lying in the tomb. So during Lent, 2 days of fast, Ash Wednesday and Good Friday. But also within the context of Lent, I guess to call it in its completion, is Holy Saturday. So some people will say that in Lent, it's only really one day of fast, Ash Wednesday, because the Paschal Triduum has already begun on Holy Thursday, and then Good Friday and Holy Saturday we're asked to fast again. But in the Hebrew scriptures, we see that they fasted very much. Our fast during the season of Lent must be our works of mercy, to right the wrong, to forgive those who offended us, and to reach out to people who are in need of our help. That's the greatest gift. A heart that is contrite and humble, O God, you will not spurn. The disciples of John approached Jesus and said, "Why do we and the Pharisees fast much, but your disciples do not fast?" Jesus answered them, "Can the wedding guests mourn as long as the bridegroom is with them? The days will come when the bridegroom is taken away from them, and then they will fast." So our understanding of fast, maybe a food and drink, but more importantly, fasting from those things that are not part of the Christian life. And then making sure that we do something very quickly, that we feed the hungry, give drink to the thirsty, clothe the naked, visit the imprisoned, the almsgiving, the charity, must be the hallmark of the Christian life. think we understand that better and better each day. That doesn't mean that we throw out the baby with the bathwater. That just means that we understand it in its completion as Jesus gives it to us. As today is a day of abstinence, that is, not to have any meat products today, as an offering to the Lord. We're reminded of that every Friday of the year, but by obligation on the Fridays of Lent. May you and I hold fast and understand completely what Christ is speaking of in the Gospel, and then do it with love and devotion, so that we may be more in union with Him each and every day. After reflecting on God's holy word, let us now place these petitions before the Lord with confidence and trust.
For all members of the church, may God draw us ever closer to Himself during this Lenten season. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For leaders of nations and all those in authority, may God guide them in governing with wisdom and compassion. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who struggle with mental illness, may God's healing grace come upon them. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For this community of faith, may the Holy Spirit enkindle in us a fire for the corporal works of mercy during this Lenten season. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, may they rejoice with God in their eternal home in heaven. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick and suffering, Jackie Fardy, Suzanne Kazaza, Carol and Robbie Casanita, and all those on our prayer list, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for Marie and Harry Bayshore, for whom this Mass is being offered, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. We also pray for the spiritual and temporal needs of St. Mary's Parish, so that all of us may further the mission of Jesus. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us also pray for an increase in vocations to the priesthood and consecrated life, especially for members of our own parish family. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Good and gracious God, we place these petitions before you. If they are in accord with your holy will, we ask you to grant them in Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed
are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. Grace, Susan, brothers, my sacrifice and yours, may be accepted. acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at their hands, for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
We offer you, O Lord, the sacrifice of our Lenten observance, praying that it may make our intentions acceptable to you, and add to our powers of self-restraint, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just that we should always give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for you do not cease to spur us on to possess a more abundant life, and being rich in mercy, you constantly offer pardon and call on sinners to trust in your forgiveness alone. Never did you turn away from us, and though time and again we have broke your covenant, you have bound the human family to yourself through Jesus, your Son, our Redeemer, with a new bond of love so tight that it can never be undone. Even now, you set before your people a time of grace and reconciliation. And as they turn back to you in spirit, you grant them hope in Christ Jesus and a desire to be of service to all, while they entrust themselves more fully to the Holy Spirit. And so, filled with wonder, we extol the power of your love, and proclaiming our joy at the salvation that comes from you, we join in the heavenly hymn of countless hosts, as without end we acclaim. Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and from the world's beginning are ceaselessly at work, so that the human race may become holy, just as you yourself are holy. Look, we pray, upon your people's offerings, and pour out on them the power of your Spirit, that they may become the body and blood of your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, in whom we look, in whom we too are your sons and daughters. Even though we were lost and could not approach you, you loved us with greater love, for your Son, who alone is just, handed himself over to death and did not disdain to be nailed for our sake to the wood of the cross. But before his arms were outstretched between heaven and earth to become the lasting sign of your covenant, he desired to celebrate the Passover with his disciples. As he ate with them, he took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to them, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, knowing that he was about to reconcile all things in himself, through his blood to be shed on the cross, he took the chalice filled with the fruit of the vine, and once more giving you thanks, handed the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of your Son, Jesus Christ, who is our Passover and our surest peace, we celebrate his death and resurrection from the dead, and looking forward to his blessed coming, we offer you, who are our faithful and merciful God, this sacrificial victim who reconciles to you the human race. Look kindly, most compassionate Father, on those you unite to yourself by the sacrifice of your Son, and grant that by the power of the Holy Spirit, as they partake of this one bread and one chalice, they may be gathered into one body in Christ, who heals every division. Be pleased to keep us always in communion of mind and heart, together with Francis, our Pope, and Nelson, our Bishop, his assistant bishops. Help us to work together for the coming of your kingdom, until the hour when we stand before you, saints among the saints in the halls of heaven, with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints, and with our deceased brothers and sisters, whom we commend to your mercy. Then, freed at last from the womb of corruption and made fully into a new creation, we may sing to you with gladness the thanksgiving of Christ, who lives for all eternity. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with all of you.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Now is the time. myself fully to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. O my God, my only hope, I have placed all my trust in you, and I know I shall not be disappointed.
Let us pray. We pray, Almighty God, that through partaking of this mystery, we may be cleansed of all our misdeeds, and so be suited for the remedies of your compassion. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen. Two announcements. The first one, today's Eucharistic prayer. It was from our missal, according to the Eucharistic prayers of reconciliation. Besides the four Eucharistic prayers, there's other Eucharistic prayers that the priest may offer. And that one today was of reconciliation. And it's recommended that it could be done during Lent. So I thought, I think I'm going to take that advantage and pray that Eucharistic prayer. I really loved it. I apologize for just being very deliberate, so to speak, because I don't pray that prayer all the time, and I have to be careful what I'm saying, because I'm not just reading a prayer, I'm trying to pray a prayer. And so I think you get it, right? So when you're trying to pray something, you're a little bit more deliberate. So once in a while, there's going to be some speed bumps along the way. The second thing is, because of this weather, it's not so conducive to being on campus. word.
Amen.
Now, may God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
Have a nice and very safe day, everybody.
Thank you, Father.
Saint Michael.
The Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl about the world, seeking the ruin of souls. Amen.